it further wear down credibility when you put someone who's under state, local, federal, and international investigation as a representative of your party on committees? I'm talking about George Santos, representative from New York.
We should have that discussion. So let's have that discussion. You want to bring up Santos, and let's talk about the institution itself, because I agree wholeheartedly that Congress is broken.
That's interesting that you use the word agree there, Kevin McCarthy, because she hadn't been saying that. She was actually talking about something else, and you seem to understand that because you said you want to have a conversation about George Santos. Then you immediately pivoted to something that was very much not George Santos. But maybe I'm being unfair. After all, maybe eventually he's going to get to it and he's going to address the questions that just won't go away. Well, let's take a look at how the rest of that interview went.
I think your listeners or viewers should understand what proxy voting was, because it never took place in Congress.
But I'm asking
before.
About George Santos.
I know you asked me a question. Let me
because
ask you.
Because you could put it to a vote.
You asked me a question. I'd appreciate if you let me answer. So let's go through this, because it's not one simple answer.
If now, you got a third of your caucus to vote to oust him, you could do so. You don't think you could get your Republicans to do that?
I wasn't finished answering the question.
So you're just not going to answer the question I asked?
Well, no, you don't get to question whether I answer it. You asked a question. I'm trying to get you through that.
I don't think you've said the name George Santos like once.
You know what?
You're talking about proxy voting and other things.
But you started the question with Congress was broken, and I agreed with you.
No, they're wrapping me in the control room because
we're going to break. Well, that's unfortunate. I wish I could answer the question.
I have to leave it there.
Yeah, he sure thinks it's unfortunate that, he just didn't get around to answering the question. Or as he said when she rightly interrupted him, when he said, you haven't let me finish answering the question. Boy, you didn't start answering the question. And his little defense where he's like, yeah, well, but when you first said it, you said the word Congress. Okay, technically, but I think we all know what question she was answering. You can't be like, well, I'm just going to talk about the decorations of the room because you asked the question in the room, so technically you freed me up to talk about whatever I want. No, it is very clear, one, that he does not want to have to talk about George Santos, obviously, and I sort of understand that, and two, that he's not as clever as he thinks he is, and not as good at, weaseling around the questions. That was embarrassing. It is obvious what he thinks, how unsure he is that the Republicans either should or would actually boot George Santos from the party or from Congress, to whatever extent they have that ability. And so, I don't know, Elise, I just think it's hilarious that this is such an, from my point of view, a layup. The guy's an insane liar. You can prove, you can show yourselves to be even sort of like fake honest by at least distancing yourself from him, but they won't even do that.
No, it just is the epitome of what he is right now. And he's the leader, supposedly, but I think it's clear with this and everything else that he's just not somebody who has much power or control. He doesn't really dictate what happens. He's really just a guy that is taking orders from other people. And he will mosey around answers because he really doesn't have much power. He's He sacrificed everything he believes in to have the title he has now. And and now we're just seeing the effects of that.
Yeah. And we know that there are some in the Republican Party that feel like we might say for him that, so he's not condemning. He's not really condemning George Santos, and he's certainly not trying to kick him out of the party. But at least he's not like really speaking out in defense of him, although he did say that he was elected by the constituents, which is technically true, but he knows how dishonest that is. And then you have people like Marjorie Greene that are just open boosters of George Santos. And the thing is, Marjorie Greene technically is not the Speaker of House. Technically, George Santos is. But if it came down to choosing between Kevin McCarthy and Marjorie Greene, where do we think the Republican base would go? Who do you think that they feel like a more warmth towards, Elise?
Well, I think Marjorie Taylor Greene has a lot more say in the House now than she did last year because of a majority, but also because she has a lot of control with Kevin McCarthy now. But I also think that she's just down for whatever is going to create the most ruckus. I mean, she's not really for the American people or any policy in particular. She's just for blowing things up. And she'll be pro George Santos because he's drama and she loves drama.
Yeah, and I'm sure, you know, he needs allies. I'm sure she would like some allies. I don't know how powerful of one he is. although each of his different personas might have a little bit of power. And when you add them together, then maybe that's something. I don't know. But that's just, if you're going to give a performance like that, my advice to Kevin McCarthy would be just don't go on the news. Like, honestly, what are you, if you can't come up with, like, he had almost a defense when he's like, who are you talking about? Eric Swalwell or whatever. Like, no, obviously that's not who she's talking about. But at least then you can talk about, like, well, he's made all of these horrendous objective lies about the Holocaust, his mom dying and all that. And then you have Eric Swalwell, where we have a conspiracy theorem about a Chinese spy or something. You could try to create a little bit of ambiguity there, but he couldn't stick to it. He started talking about proxy voting and nobody's asking about that. Nobody cares about that. You're not convincing anyone.
You'd think a career politician would be better at spinning, but no.
Yeah, that's one of the main skills that they're supposed to have.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.